away from me. I don't need that. I don't want to hurt you, but I won't let you hurt me neither.
Captain, I don't think this is a smart thing for me to be doing.
Internal error, not found, talks, anim, game aborted. Well, good thing I've been saving. Alright, let's try not to mess with this guy then.
Go away! You'll hurt me like you hurt them! I know! You're out to get me! Keep away from me! Keep away from me!
Keep away from me!
Captain, I don't think...
I don't know what else I did that...
Gormagon is one...
I just want to save what we did.
Like so many of...
Now I noticed there were no plants in this room, right?
Jim, he has...
There's something green here, though. What is this? Is this anything?
A room which appears to...
Alright. Anyone want a blanket?
Fiendishly subtle, indubitably clever, and completely unexpected, which means nothing happens.
How is it clever?
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that.
Let's throw a blanket on a Klingon.
Fiendishly subtle.
Alright, fiendishly stuff.
Save new game, replace pre.
Can we. We haven't used Spock yet, have we?
You stay away from my brother! What do you want with him? Do you want a fight? I love a good fight!
Look out, Racketback! They're up to no good!
Hey! What you trying to do?
Trying to be a wise guy over here.
As long as he remains conscious, his extreme paranoia will prevent a mind meld with him.
Well, and plus we've got this human barrier here.
If you want the bear, you'll have to beat me at this game of chess.
This reminds me of some people's quarters at the academy.
Yours, perhaps?
I wasn't about to name anyone, Bones.
Nah.
Violence is not.
Jim, given the mental states of these people, the less damage we do to their environment, the better.
In other words, Doctor, if we don't need something for our mission, we shouldn't touch it.
That's my recommendation.
Oh, we're still gonna mess around.
Jim, given the.
In other words, Doctor.
That's my recommendation. Jim.
In other words,
that's my recommendation.
All right.
I don't understand any of this, Jim.
He's scanning the teddy bear.
Not a lifelike representation, Captain. This little bear, or whatever it's really supposed to be, doesn't register. Not like that's a surprise.
Nope.
I'm a doctor, not a nanny. This appears to be an unusual metallic structure. I don't understand any of this, Jim. I don't understand. Chess isn't really my game, Captain.
Uhura?
Captain, there's got to be a better way to handle this. Captain, there's got to be a better... This appears to be an unusual metallic structure.
We haven't heard that before.
Captain, I suggest we encourage these people to clean up after themselves. Captain, there's got... Captain, there's... The best move I can find would only end the game with a draw, Captain. I'm sure even you could do better than that. The best move you can see will end the game with a draw. But then you're more of a poker player than a chess master.
Alright, Spock. Just scanning it.
Not a lifelike representation.
Oh, that's not Spock. I'll have to tell them apart sometimes. I'm sure they'd love hearing that.
A large... I do not see the relevance of an overturned toy box to our mission.
This entire madhouse reminds me of an overturned toy box, Mr. Spock.
True.
I do not see the logic in that action. I do not see the logic in that action. I do not see the... This appears to be an unusual metallic structure.
Mm-hmm. All right, before we play chess, let's save the...
Save new game.
The game. Replace
A complex situation. However, check and mate.
How'd you do that?
Booyah!
He cheated you, brother! He must have cheated you!
No, mm-hmm. That's a legal move. Here. Take the bear. I promised, and I do what I say.
Well, you're a good boy.
I think it's a dumb game. That's what I think of this game.
Temper, temper.
I think it's a dumb game. That's what I think of this game.
You've said that. Oh, we've got a big teddy bear.
A fuzzy animal-shaped toy that looks a bit like a bear.
I don't suppose we can learn anything new about it.
Nothing unusual.
Nope.
The chess game has been scattered across the floor and the board broken. There's not enough left to play on or with after Rakabak's tantrum.
Jim, given the mental...
In other words, Doctor, if...
That's my recommendation.
Okay. Does anyone want the teddy bear?
What fever dream inspired this idea? What fever dream inspired this idea?
That's hilarious. Can we get any of this stuff?
Jim, given the mental...
In other words, Doctor, if we don't...
That's my recommendation.
We're not supposed to get anything.
I do not see the toy box's relevance to this mission.
Jim, give...
In other words, Doctor...
That's my recommendation.
I listened to my brother Rakabak, and...
What would you say, Gormakan? He's just...
Same.
I'm more interested in a good...
Yeah.
You get no response.
I don't care who you say you are! You're evil monsters in disguise!
Uh-huh.
Captain Kirk, dealing with Tusken should be your first priority.
You want help from me?
Okay. Well, I have no idea what to do with any of this stuff.
Fiendishly so.
Want a teddy bear?
The Klingon officer looks at you with something approaching pity.
That's funny.
The Klingon sneers at you with unmistakable disdain.
I don't want a teddy bear.
What fever dream? What
fever dream? That's funny. I can't think of anything to do with anything, so.
Save new game. Replace.
Can we walk further into the room? Nope.
Captain, if I may interject, that disparity is something we glimpsed throughout this ship.
I was thinking the same thing myself, Lieutenant. I'd like to have a talk with...
And I also, Captain Kirk. I believe...
What does it have to do with her... Okay, never mind. We can't advance further into the room. Let's try back this way. I'm not even sure we've seen all the quarters. Is there anything down here? Nope. Does this guy want a teddy bear, though?
I'm not going to talk to you.
He's not going to talk to us. Alright, let's leave this room. Guys want a teddy bear?
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
How about a blanket?
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Welcome back. Are you feeling better?
No. We weren't hungry.
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Hello there, Kirk. Welcome, all of you. You're not feeling well, are you?
I'm feeling fine. Let's drop the subject.
Sounds like a great idea.
I want some information from you, Faze. Why? How are you feeling? Aren't you feeling well? I'm feeling fine. Let's drop the subject. Why? I want some information from you, Faze.
You feel that information will be helpful to you?
Yeah.
Then of course I want to help. What would you like information about?
You.
The most important thing is for me to find out how to stop you from landing on the colony on Atabus. What are you? What are you doing here? Tell me about your history, and I'm sure that will be helpful.
That too?
The most important thing. What are you?
The Builders installed the Parallels Library to help with questions such as yours. But I'm afraid Tuscan came in when he wasn't feeling well.
Huh.
He seems to have damaged the library. We are attempting to repair it. This ship, the Compassion, was created by the Builders to carry the folk like you. The damaged ones. Asleep. We were the very best intelligence the Builders could install. Although now that a few generations have passed, I'm certain I will find ourselves an ancient relic. The entire purpose was that, given time, the Builders would find cures, solutions to the kinds of difficulties you and the others here experience. After we land, they will make you feel good.
Yeah.
Better even than when you've eaten well and are happy.
Sleeper ship, Captain. The Builders loaded up all the undesirables and shipped them off planet. So why is everyone here awake?
Not undesirable! No, Dr. McCoy, you are beloved of the Builders and of us! Why else would I be programmed to keep you safe? Wake you before landing, and we all return to Chavrum to be welcomed by your great-grandchildren!
Captain, if I may, two questions, Faze. How long ago did you wake us up? And how much time has passed since this ship was launched by the Builders?
Good
you
questions.
Were awakened shortly before we were to land. We were launched 99 Ikens ago.
Can you translate that into the half-life of some radioactive isotope for me?
Half the Clever. Isotope of Silicon 32 has decayed away since our voyage together began.
Captain, the Faze is saying it has only been in space approximately 280 Earth years.
That's very clever.
Atabus does have ruins, the most recent of which are in excess of 1,000 years old, but no sentient life. Otherwise, it would have been unsuitable for Federation colonization. Moreover, the readings I took while still aboard the Enterprise indicated this ship had probably been in space more like 1,600 years.
Can you translate that into the half-life of some radioactive isotope for us, Mr. Spock?
Touché.
By my instrumentation, radium-226 has half-decayed into radon-222 in the time you have been in space, Faze.
You are mistaken. What instruments could you have possibly been using without my knowledge, Mr. Spock? The external monitors are inaccessible to the folk on board, as you well know. It would hardly do for someone as confused as you clearly are.
Thanks.
To get into sensitive areas. I suggest you go get something to eat. You are clearly not thinking nor feeling well.
Faze, is it possible you're not thinking or not feeling well?
Touché indeed.
Faze, are you aware that we are not even from there? That we are from another ship, a different planet altogether? That Mr. Spock here isn't even the same race as the other three of us?
Also a good one.
Faze, are you aware that we are not even from there?
Is there something more you'd like to talk about? Or do you want to get some rest? Wouldn't you like to be better rested and feeling better?
No, I don't think that. I just as soon stop talking about it.
Answer the questions, FaZe.
FaZe, scan me. Scan the others here with me. Scan the people elsewhere on the ship. Are we even the same race? No, I don't think. FaZe, scan me.
You aren't well, that's true. Recognizing that you're not well is the first step toward getting the help you need, Captain Kirk.
Scan us.
I will help you if you like. Although, first, you should get some food and some rest. Do you think you'd like that?
No, I don't think that. I just as soon stop talking about it.
You will feel better after you eat, dear. Run along now. I'm very busy.
Sheesh.
You can come back to talk to us again another time.
Huh. Are you feeling well? Would you like a blanket?
No, I don't think that...
Hello there, Kirk.
I'm feeling fine. Let's drop the subject. I want some information. Why? How are you feeling? Aren't you feeling well?
I am fine, Captain Kirk. Is there something that makes you believe that we are not thinking or not feeling well?
No, I don't think that. You're in charge of a starship that's declaring the intent to land on top of innocent colonists. Do you want me to blow up the ship? No, I don't think that. I just as soon stop talking about it. You're in charge of a starship that's declared...
Do you have a great deal of anger to express, Captain Kirk?
Sometimes.
Some of us do. Even we do sometimes. I can't go to the playroom, but you can, you know. Work off some of your anger and frustration. Wouldn't you like that?
What do you need to learn? How can I make you understand there are sentients who will die if you land at Atavus?
That's a clever question, Captain Kirk. You're not well, yet you want me to tell you how to trick us.
What?
However, you cannot access my external monitors. So in any event, you cannot trick us into thinking something exists which does not. If the planet we are approaching had homes where I know a starship landing field exists, I certainly would not land. However, the builders would not be so foolish. They knew we would return. And when? You don't understand. That's to be expected. The damaged ones have difficulty understanding sometimes. Just know that we love you. And we'll care for you until the builders can ease the confusion in your minds. Wouldn't you like that?
FaZe, are you aware that we are not even from there? No, I don't think that. FaZe, are you aware? No, I don't think
that. You will feel better.
Well, this isn't getting us anywhere. What about these plants?
No, I don't think that's necessary. No, I don't think that's necessary.
Would he like a blankie?
Jake C picks up the blanket with a somber expression and tries hugging it.
Prickly blanket. Blocks nicer.
He's good at playing the chess, so they said. Aww.
Soft. Nice. You get blocks now?
He gathers together the blocks and gives them out to you.
Oh. I don't know what we can do with the blocks. Cool. Got blocks. We can play now.
Multicolored blocks, suitable for a child to play with.
Yay! We haven't gone through the store either, I don't think.
A gridwork of manufactured plastic to diffuse the illumination transmitted from the lighting system in the ceiling.
I meant to hit this.
The blocks are an unusual organic substance.
He said that before. We can't get this?
I don't see how...
Okay.
I'm Captain James T. Kirk.
Jake C.
What can you tell me about this place, Jake C?
The sweet-faced adult shakes his head no.
It says no. Can we get these other blocks?
You get blocks now?
Yeah.
He smiles broadly as you take the blocks.
So now we've got even more blocks? Well, we just have the same blocks we already did. Okay.
I'm Captain James T. Kirk.
Jake C.
What can you tell me about this? Can you smile for me, Jake C?
The sweet-faced...
Can't smile. Let's save. We go through here. This might be the only room we haven't been to. Ah! Hello there. Oh, and hello there. These guys are such a pain.
The captain is unmoved by the appearance of this room.
So yeah, it looks like a sick bay.
The Vulcan scrutinizes the room, finding it functional but with little to spark the interest of his analytical mind.
There's a lot to see in this place.
A wan-looking female stands dejectedly, her shoulders slumped. Her whole appearance expresses deep worry and bone-crushing weariness.
That's sad.
Bones seems to find these facilities of particular interest, especially the medical area. The lieutenant is concerned by the weary look on the face of the person in the room. A Klingon crew...
Same descriptions.
This room gives the impression of being two disparate things joined for an obscure reason. There's a space to eat in, and a medical area that doesn't fit with the place to eat paradigm. At least it wouldn't fit together at most places in Federation space.
Yeah, I can see that.
A mechanized food delivery and recycling system not unlike what you see every day aboard the Enterprise. An unremarkable piece of furniture offering nothing but a flat surface from which to eat while standing up.
Not a very good height either. You'd be bent over looking at it. I mean, eating at it.
A simple sliding door. A computer terminal with various access ports, a scanning rod, and a workspace. A large machine made from a red metal. This room gives the...
Alright.
The food supply may be at the crux of the problem on the ship. I recommend a close examination of the ship's food whenever possible.
Absolutely.
Captain, it appears that the inhabitants of this ship take it as given that food and medication go naturally together. With all respect to Dr. McCoy, I would dislike having a physician medicating all food that passed my lips.
Agreed.
Captain, I'm seeing all these people as being under medication, or needing to be. And they're all unhealthy in one way or another. It really doesn't surprise me that they associate food and medicine. Their veins are probably always swimming with some chemical stew.
Captain, I think that woman looks like someone we should talk to.
We will.
The food supply may be at the crux of the problem on the ship. I recommend a close examination of the ship's food whenever possible.
Oh, what's this? I can't even look at it, because...
This room gives...
Alright. What's that?
This appears to be a kind of all-purpose first aid station and medical dispensary. With computer-aided diagnostics. Captain, from the configuration of equipment here, it is possible for someone to use this machine as a workstation and prepare medicine for someone who, for example, would be unable to come to the station for treatment.
What's dish?
This machine appears to be made from solid uranium steel. It appears to contain computer processors for the medical unit. I detect numerous redundant circuits and fail-safes.
Reminds me of Vulcan anatomy.
That is illogical, Captain. I mean, Doctor.
This mechanized food delivery and recycling system is similar to the Enterprise's system. One significant difference is that it includes a scanning feature on the person making the request for food. I also note that the machinery accepts used dishes and reusable materials for recycling. Since this ship is a narrowly enclosed system, Captain, of the various mental conditions we have seen among the inhabitants of this ship, most, although not all, have been nonviolent. Dr. McCoy may need to examine this data further, but I believe through the food dispensary, the individuals aboard this ship are regularly medicated, often tranquilized.
Well, maybe they're medicated when they don't need to be, and they'd be fine if they didn't take this crap.
A metal and plastic construct, slightly over a meter high, built into the floor. Female of early middle age, of unremarkable weight and overall condition.
Don't worry, Captain Kirk. If I have something to say to you, I'll speak up. You can be quite sure of that.
Oh, goody.
Don't bother me, you.
Don't bother me, you.
You get no response.
Well, you can't look at it, right? Because then the bag pops up, and I guess there's nothing there.
A female, just moving into middle age. Her overall level of health is fairly good. Vital signs are down marginally. Mental readings indicate a chemical array typical of severe depression. However, there are high levels of tranquilizing chemicals in her bloodstream.
She's tranquilized and depressed. I guess we're talking to her. Before I do that, let me save.
Save new game. Replace.
Hi there, I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise. Who are you?
Good choice.
Are you feeling all right, ma'am? Can you tell me what the problem is? You look so sad. Would it help to tell us why you look so down? Hi there, I'm Captain James T. Kirk of the Starship Enterprise.
Yeah.
Who are you?
Standard greeting.
I'm called Moll.
Moll?
My son is Stan Bob, and I failed him.
Stan Bob.
I feel so badly. I'm a terrible mother.
The woman's eyes brim with tears, and she can't continue the conversation.
Oh, the kid that's rocking back and forth in the sleeping chamber.
I'm reluctant to medicate any of these people, Captain. She seems to have a chemical stew in her veins already, and I'd be concerned about unpredictable drug interactions.
Yeah, I knew it.
I think this machine is more up your alley, Dr. McCoy. No, I don't think that's necessary.
It's an inelegant design, but nevertheless a good height for an adult to stand up and eat at.
Doesn't look high enough.
The woman seems withdrawn and distant, difficult to talk to.
Let me get some foodstuffs out of here.
The machine whirs, lights blink, and a prepackaged container of food is deposited on the tray.
Now it scanned me in order to determine, well, it scanned him in order to determine what food we should get. Doesn't it scan us and notice that this, we're not among the people here? Can I get something?
No effect. No effect. No effect.
We can't get the thing on the tray?
No effect.
Get the thing.
Just the box of prepared food is light and compact.
Okay, we got it, right? Just don't eat it, whatever you do.
This room gives the impression...
No. There's the food, right?
A prepackaged meal.
Analyze, Mr. Spock.
A reprocessed cellulose-based container with prepared nutritional components inside, appropriate as a meal for one individual. In addition, the food appears to be laced with a variety of drugs, which Dr. McCoy could better analyze than I.
Make it so.
As a meal, the food in this little box is a tad high in carbohydrates by human nutritional standards. Still, it would supply about one quarter to one third of a day's average caloric needs, and includes protein, fats, fiber, bitter spices, and flavorings. There are also drugs in the food, some of which we added, you know. It's quite heavy on the alkaloid tranquilizers.
What? We added it? That's not what that says.
As a meal, the food in this little box is a tad high in carbohydrates by human nutritional standards. Still, it would supply
calmatives and tranquilizer class drugs, some endorphin-like euphorics. We added. So is that a glitch telling us that we can add stuff for the food to give them to them? Maybe by using his med kit.
She doesn't look well, Jim. It might be more useful were I to examine or try to talk with her.
It's an inelegant design.
This seems to be a non-emergency medical station. A first aid stop, you might say. Jim, I think if I check it out with my tricorder as a translation device, I might begin to better understand these people.
Good idea.
I don't see any visible controls on that, Jim.
Captain, I don't think another one would be very useful.
All right. Let's analyze it then.
This computer gives me some standards against which to correlate data, Jim. These people are humanoid, certainly. But it would be a dangerous mistake to assume specific details of treatment would be the same. I can even use this workspace to concoct medicine if I've got the stuff to work with.
Quite a long episode, huh?
It's an inelegant...
So what does he say again? Hold on, I wasn't really...
This computer gives me some standards against which to correlate data, Jim. These people are humanoid, certainly. But it would be a dangerous mistake to assume specific...
So he can use this as a workspace if he's got materials to work with.
It's an inelegant...
Captain, there are no accessible controls on that unit. I believe Dr. McCoy will find this more informative than I. Nevertheless, tricorder readings may enable me to make some useful suggestions.
Captain, I don't think another one would be very useful.
Well, he's already scanned it, but let's see if he says anything different now.
This appears to be a kind of all-purpose first aid station and medical dispensary with computer-aided diagnostics.
Probably what he said before.
I could try to talk with her if you wish, Captain.
Yeah, she is the communication officer.
I think this female would be more likely to benefit by Dr. McCoy's attentions, or perhaps Lieutenant Uhura's.
Now, when we choose when we choose a character, like when you choose Uhura...
I could try to talk with her if you wish, Captain.
And then we use talk. It seems to be her that goes.
Hi there, I'm Captain James T. Kirk. Are you feeling all right, ma'am? Can you tell me what the problem is?
I'm a bad mother. I tried to do right, get him what he wants and needs. Just so depressed. Everything died.
Who died? What died? I'd like to help if I can.
I did. I'm a bad person. Killed all the plants, and now they don't produce anymore. I'm not worthy to have a good son like him.
A mother's job can be difficult. I'm sure you did your best for your son. Would you care to tell me about it? Why do you think you were the one who killed the plants? Have you even looked in on them recently? What if someone showed you that you were wrong? A mother's job can be difficult. I'm sure you did your best for your son.
Little Stan, Bob. I try to feed him right, give him safe food. He really likes fresh fruit. Now he can't have it anymore, and it's all my fault.
Ma'am, hold on to this idea. It may not be your fault at all. We'll try to help. You have my word. Your son still loves you just for trying. Of that I'm certain. He wouldn't want you to be so sad. Ma'am, hold on to this idea. It may not be your fault at all. Your son still loves you just for trying.
The woman's eyes brim with tears, and she can't continue the conversation.
Aww.
Hi there, I'm Captain James T. Are you feeling all right, ma'am? You look so sad. Would it help to tell us why you look so down?
Do you have any children, sir? I do, a son, and I've just not treated him right. Tried to do right, but everything died, and I can't give him what he wants, what I think he needs.
A mother's job can be difficult. What died? Did you hurt somebody? Something? A mother's job, what died?
I was thinking of hurting myself, and the phase told me that wasn't good. That was true, and I got something to eat and felt better.
Huh.
When I tend the plants in the garden, some of them died. The ones that give fresh fruit.
You didn't mean to kill the plants, did you?
No, of course not. Before Tuscan ruined the reader in the phase oratory, I read about those plants. They need phosphorus, nitrogen, ammonia, and calcium compounds to grow their best.
In the blocks.
Something's wrong now. I think that's how I killed them. Plants aren't getting fertilized, and I don't know how to fix it.
The woman's eyes brim with tears, and she can't continue the conversation.
Those are the materials in the blocks we took, I'm pretty sure of it. At least some of them. I think all of them.
Hi there, I'm Captain James T. Are you feeling all right, ma'am? Can you tell me-
I'm a bad mother. I tried to-
Who died? What died? I'd like to help if I can.
I did it. I'm a bad person.
A mother's job can be. Why do you think you were the one who...
I'm eating what the phase makes for me, so I'm just resting. I'm tired, and I really don't feel like doing anything. I'd be so happy to know my boy could have safe food again. It's better for him than what the phase provides, I think. But I killed the plants. They're dead, and I can't make them better.
The woman's eyes brim with tears, and she can't continue the conversation.
Save new game. Replace.
You go through here.